Should we start? Hardik, how many you already logged in? Just write a message to me.
Saran, please announce when we are on live.
Yes, we are going to.
Yeah, you can comb your hair right now.
Sir, live here.
Nivas, sir, we are already live there. We are already streaming now.
Okay, I think you can press.
On behalf of RSSDI, this is our third match of Indian Diabetes League, or we can say it's a Diabetes Premier League. So today I request our President-elect, Dr. Vasant Kumar, to make few introductory remarks. Dr. Vasant Kumar, please.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you, Dr. Bansi, our dynamic president who made this possible, this wonderful programs that we've been having. Actually, it's a great fun and enjoyment. Also, it's a great learning experience. So today we look forward to have one more enjoyable program and also learn more from both of our colleagues' parties. Let's see who will do better. As I was already mentioning to you, I wish best of luck to both the teams and we'll be eagerly sitting in the stadium and watching you both. Back to Dr. Bansi.
Yes, thank you, Dr. Vasant Kumar. So as we know, there are controversies and which will be always there. And diabetes, there are many controversies. So we decided to keep a dedicated 90-minute slot for just controversies. And we will be discussing during this program of Indian Diabetes League, these different controversies which we have, and two different teams of our state chapters, they will be discussing. And it's like a fun. And at the same time, we will be learning the science also. Today also we have an opportunity that there are many doctors who are getting registered from the respective state only. So I mean from Andhra and from Assam, like we have almost 75% of their physicians population is already registered. So it's an opportunity for RSSDI that if we are reaching to the these many number of physicians, are RSSDI reaching them, and we also have that they can become the member of our RSSDI. There's an idea also behind this ideal. The third is that we want that all state chapters and their speakers should also come at the national platform. So that's the reason why we had created the Indian Diabetes League, as the rules will be announced by the umpires. But first I invite two moderators for this program, which we call them commentators. Dr. Kalyan Gangopadhyay from Kolkata, who is a senior endocrinologist. Kalyan is very actively involved for making the program of this ideal. And we have Dr. Arun Shankar from Patna, from Bihar, who will be moderating and they are the commentators for the today's game. So over to Dr. Kalyan and to Dr. Anand Shankar for further proceedings. Dr. Kalyan.
Thank you, Bansi, and good evening, good evening, good evening, everybody, and namaskar. So today, get ready for a very exciting match. You know, the two states, they already have got A. You know, both have got A's. You know, Assam begins with A, Andhra Pradesh begins with A. So both are winners to begin with. Now, I also welcome my co-commentator, Dr. Anand Shankar. Anand, how are you doing?
I'm fine, sir. How are you?
Yes, I'm quite excited. I have seen all the players just beforehand talking to each other. And there is a, you know, not quite, but quite vocal excitement amongst all the players. Now, let me tell you a little bit about Assam. And my friend Anand will tell you a little bit about Andhra Pradesh. You know, Assam, you know, they are the tigers. Why? You know, they have Kaziranga. It's the world's highest concentration of tigers. Is there in Kaziranga. So if you go to Kaziranga and if you don't spot a tiger, don't worry, the tiger has definitely spotted you. And I think Assam, you know, forgive me the ladies in the program, but they have got the male power. Why? Because the only male river in the whole of India runs through Assam, which is Brahmaputra. If any of you have seen Brahmaputra, you will understand why it is called a male river. And it's, I think, the only one which has got an island in it. I have been to Assam many times, and you know, on the dance, the Bihu dance, they have got Bagarumba dance, the Jumur dance. The Bihu dance in particular, whenever they play it, is always, you know, Vikas Bhatchaj and Karuna Varman is sitting by my side. I cannot stop myself from standing up and clapping. It's an involuntarily, you will stand up. The beat is such. So I think it is called the land of red rivers and blue hills. A beautiful place. You know, it's fascinating that our country, each and every state is like a country. So such is Assam. The variety, the beauty, if you ever grow from Guwahati to the place where the highest rainfall named Cherrapunji. The journey is so enthralling. It's as if you are going through the clouds. It's a fascinating place. Now, I will hand over to Anand Shankar to tell us a little bit about Andhra Pradesh, the other A.
The other A is absolutely bubbling. Andhra Pradesh is bubbling and producing a quality of cricketers from Andhra Pradesh. You know, we have first smell the winning of cricket team from Ajharuddin, and we called him Ajju. So Ajju, Ajharuddin, Andhra Pradesh is fighting nothing like that. And we are very proud to have like BVS Lakshman. You know, cricketers never will forget BVS Lakshman. And you know, Andhra Pradesh has produced a BVS Lakshman like cricketer. We have been Raidu, we have Raju. These are the cricketers from Andhra Pradesh. And Andhra Pradesh is not a Pradesh, it is a country itself. As my co-commentator has said, that India itself a multiple country, and Andhra Pradesh is a holistic approaching state of India. And I congratulate Andhra Pradesh to fight like Andhris. So I hand over mic to my commentator. Where he has gone? Kalyan, sir. Kalyan,
yes, I'm here. I'm very much here.
So what you say about the players? How the...
I can say that from Assam, there have always been very good players of diabetes. If you have been there in the CMEs of fascinating set of questions, always ready. So I think the players are, you know, they are brimming with confidence. I've seen their faces. They are brimming with confidence. But I think, Anand, the pitch, I'm a bit worried about the pitch. You know, the pitch has got a bit of grass in it. Because you see, the pitch, by the pitch, I mean the topic. You know, it's diabetes can be reversed. So I think that's a very slippery pitch. It has got a lot of grass on it and it might bounce. And I fear that some of the players might put a lot of bounces in it.
So I think, sir, the pitch, what Google Pitch is saying, that when I write on Google, the reversal of diabetes, and that so 200,000 sites in just half a second. So you see the pitch in the Google is very slippery. So we have to the players, all are very much to be control of the ball and the bats. You need sixes more and the bouncers are ready to catch you out. So yeah, Kalyan, sir, what do you say, sir?
Yes, I think with time also the pitch is going to crack and a lot of spin is going to take place. And it will be very, very interesting to see how the players tackle it. So I think now we introduce the legend of the game, Dr. S.R. Arvind. So I will tell a few words about him. And I didn't know one thing, which I'm going to ask him as well. So he's the chief consultant at the Diakon Hospital. And he's the chief diabetologist at the Fortis Hospital in Columbia, Asia. He has been past president of RSSDI, past president of Diabetes India. He's got hundreds of publications, hundreds of phase 2-3 studies, many textbooks. I can go on and on and on about Dr. S.R. Arvind.
And he is a cricketer diabetologist of Bangalore.
Is he?
Yes,
and
sir.
You know, he has got a Guinness Book of World Record?
Yeah.
What record has he got? He has got a record for the highest number of food screenings in a day.
Yes.
So I'm going to ask him as well when he starts, what is this record? How many have you screened? So over to Dr. S.R. Arvind, the legend of the game today.
Hey, thank you, Kalyan. Thank you, Anand. I think that was a great start. And I have a few slides. I'll just request them to actually, you know, allow me to share my slides very quickly because what I have is only about 3 minutes. I will tell you what is that Guinness Book of World Records. You know, when you go out of business and then when you don't have any patients, you touch the feet of many, many people around the countryside, along the temples, and then you beg for some money. And this is exactly what JJ taught me to do. And with so many luminaries in Bangalore, you know, I got used to touching the feet. So when this opportunity came, it was easy for me to do the foot screening of that. Now, just allow me to share the slides. I hope they will quickly allow me. Yes.
Arvind, there's one part of it. Somebody did not introduce you as you are a film actor and he's acted in films also. So there's one facet nobody talked about.
I'll come back to that. Now you are actually looking at a legend, and then this legend happens to be 62 years old. So I thought I will show this because JJ will surely say, is it a single malt or it's blended? So I will come to that a little later. So when I was looking at it, you know, these are the slides that I got. You know, the kids are first benchers, the men are middle benchers, and legends are back benchers, and ultra legends stay out of the class. And I didn't see Sanjay's face. So maybe he comes in the ultra legends who stays out of the class. This is a beautiful description of a legend, a life that has attained the dignity of age. I think with that, I will stop sharing the screen. And it's important for us to talk about today's topic, which is basically the reversal of diabetes. And we know that type 2 diabetes is caused by excess of fat, which is absolutely reversible. And within the liver itself, there is excess of fat, which worsens hepatic responsiveness to insulin, leading to an increased glucose production. And it's very clearly known that with the reversal of weight and the weight reduction, this responsiveness to insulin comes back. And also within the beta cells, when once you lose weight, there is de-recognition of this, and probably there is a re-differentiation of the beta cells, and the responsive to insulin is very clearly known. And we all have heard of the DIRECT trial. But I think I will leave it to the contestants today to talk about all these things when it comes to the reversal of diabetes. But the important message to all is this. I think as a society, we can no longer afford or tolerate the continued rising rates of diabetes, which is a problem, 77 million. And despite many barriers within the healthcare system as a whole, I think the providers are responsible on a daily basis to the lives patients caught up with unprecedented epidemic. I think the current standards of care may be suitable for some, but others would surely choose reversal if they understand that there is a choice called the reversal of diabetes. And the choice can only be offered if the providers are not only aware that reversal is possible, but have the education needed to review these options in a patient-centric discussion. I think with that, I will stop and I will be a legend. I will only come into the picture if asked, not otherwise. It's over to Anand and who are the other commentators today? I'm sorry. I think Anand, I can see your face. I don't see the others. Kalyan. Kalyan, okay. Now Kalyan, you're back. So Kalyan is back, Anand is back. It's over to you people.
Okay. Well, thank you, legend, sir. Now, Anand, yes, I think sir. There is a traffic jam outside the stadium because yes, there sir. Are in excess of 1,250 delegates who have already logged in and many are logging in. And I think Dr. Sabu has gone outside to resolve this as to how to have a smooth inflow of the delegates.
The crowds are extremely screaming.
The crowd noise, you can listen here.
Yes, a lot of people. So more than
3,700 already we sold the ticket for this stadium. Already 1,250 had come and many more are going to come.
Oh, excellent, excellent. Excellent. Sabu. And I think we should congratulate Dr. Bansi Sabu, Rajiv Kovil, Tejas, Sanjay Agarwal, and there are a lot of other people involved in making this a great success. There's a lot of hard work gone into making this. So now, I think, Anand, should we invite our umpires?
Yes, sir. You please invite, sir. Please invite, sir.
Okay, so I would like to invite Dr. S.K. Sarma, sir, and Dr. Archana Sarva.
Thank you. Thank you very much. We are here, umpire.
Good evening, everyone, to this wonderful evening. Lot of excitement. And what a match it's going to be. It's very interesting to be in the position of an umpire, I think, for the first time in my life, hopefully not the last. So can I start with the rules, sir?
Absolutely. Please start.
Absolutely. So my duty is to tell the rules. So please, both the teams, both the wonderful teams, listen carefully. And we are going to be strict. We are going to be watching you. Please, please pay attention. So there are overs. The first over, that is the first speaker of the team which the captain will choose, will be given 8 minutes. And we are the timekeepers. We are not going to exceed the time. Otherwise, it will be declared a no ball. And the second over is the second speaker, and that will be 7 minutes. So 8 minutes for the first, 7 for the second. And rebuttal time for the third speaker will be 3 minutes. Okay, so once we have the time, please keep the whole target on time because that's very important in your scoring system. Then comes the language. Oh yes, I will be giving you a 1 minute reminder. Just when 1 minute is left, we will be telling you that it is 1 minute to go. And now we come to the language. We do not want any unparliamentary language. So bouncers are allowed in terms of fun and in terms of informal language. But beamers are not allowed. So that is nasty language, non-parliamentary language is not going to be accepted. If there are 2 episodes of such a language, we will have to disqualify the team. We don't expect that, but you never know with the tempers getting high and the temperature getting really high here. And there is a no ball. So you have a no ball if the time exceeds. There's a free hit, an extra 1 minute. If there is a extraordinary humor, quirky, something very interesting that has been said by the team. And this will be the umpire's decision. So Dr. S.K. Sharma Sir is with me and myself. We will be there to watch you. All the best to both the teams. And I hand over to Sharma Sir for the next step.
Thank you. Thank you, Archana. As Archana is a very tough umpire, so I think everybody will be following the rules, and now we can have the poll for this topic, which is a very important topic. So over to Hardik for showing the poll.
So the poll will be shown to the audience. This is the audience poll, Hardik. This is the audience
quiz.
Yes, quiz. So please put the audience poll. The same question and the answer you give to me, so I will send it to Dr. S.K. Sharma and Archana.
So this, while the poll is going on, I think one review per team will be allowed. Yes. So that is one thing we missed in the rules. One review can be asked for by the captain. And this will be addressed to our legend. So one review will be allowed.
So I think while we are waiting for the poll question, I would like to say one thing. I've always seen that it is always good to have a lady as an umpire. You know, whenever there is a gentleman who's an umpire, all the players start shouting, out nahi hai, out nahi hai. But when a lady says out, they will nobody will raise a single, you know.
It's a matter of creating impression, good impression.
That's why I started off, you know, on the...
Dada, legend had make lot of points. And I think so, there's a lot of gray area. So the batsman and the baller has to be very careful.
Because yes, I think, in the pitch, there are a lot of, you know, I can see rough areas from which the ball is going to bounce like anything.
And in the outfit also, I'm seeing a lot of patches. So it might be slow or fast sometimes. So the fielder has to be very careful. The rebattle is going to be very important for both of the teams.
And they have to keep their eyes and ears out for, you know, catching the review.
Yes, very much, sir. So the teams must be ready. I think leg umpire should call in the place.
Yes. Now the leg umpire, because poll is over. Leg umpire.
Okay. Good evening to all. And I welcome everybody for this very, very interesting team and very, very interesting program today. And I invite both the captains, Dr. G.R. Sridhar and Dr. P.K. Biswas, for the toss. And this is the coin. You can see both the sides of the coin.
So, you are sure that this is not the Sholay coin?
Yes, it is. Definitely. So who is going to take the head? Dr. Biswas.
Captain, please give your call.
Dr. Biswas, unmute yourself.
Dr. Sridhar, what is your?
I'll take tails.
He is taking tail.
Okay. So this is head.
So we'll bet fast.
Yes. So the team from Assam.
Yeah. Team from Assam comprises Dr. Rupam Chowdhury, Dr. Sanjeev Medhi, and Dr. Ripun Borpurjari. So our first batsman is Dr. Rupam Chowdhury.
So, Captain Dr. Biswas.
Dr. Biswas, you want to play first or you have a choice to play later also because you won the toss?
Yeah, we'll bet first.
Okay, that's great. Start.
Yeah.
So your first speaker is Dr.
Rupam Chowdhury.
Okay, good. Let us start with Rupam.
Kalyanda, I think introduce the captain and the players.
So I think the captain will introduce the players.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Before that, Hardik, can you, Rupam, please stop sharing your screen. So, Hardik, can you play the Assamese that video? Yes. Thank you. of you please share your screen?
Whatever it is, I must say, Anand, that this is definitely a very good medicine for frozen shoulder and ankylosing spondylitis.
And not only is it going to lose some calor also, sir.
Yes, of course.
Not surprisingly, we have Hima Das.
Okay, now we request the captain to introduce the players, please.
Yeah, I'm Dr. B.K. Biswas, the captain of Assam Avengers, and my teammates are Dr. Rupam Chowdhury. He's a very young, dynamic diabetologist in Guwahati. And next is our Ripun Borpujari, who is hailing from Upper Assam, is a veteran diabetologist and physician, and as well as a very good player also. When he will bowl and bat, you will see only. And we have got our Sanjeev Bedi, who is a ex-army man, so you know what in and in his physique. So I, with this little bit of introductory lectures, introductions, I end here and I ask my teammates to resume the batting first. Dr. Rupam Chowdhury, please come in.
Yes. A very good evening to all. May I start?
Yes, yes.
Yes, you can start. The time is 7:27. You have 8 minutes. Over to you.
A very good evening to all. Myself, Dr. Rupam Chowdhury. I'm the opening batsman of Assam Avengers. So today's topic is reversal of diabetes, and my stand is definitely it's a myth. So to start with, when you talk about definition of diabetes or any type of diabetes, what involves here is we know that pancreas produces little or no insulin by itself. Either it is because of autoimmune destruction or any other cause, we have decremental things from beta cells in any type of diabetes. So we also know this omnibus octet given by Dr. D. Franzo, where we see that there are multiple pathophysiologies involved in type 2 diabetes. That's why we need so many agents to counter those pathophysiologies, and also we have the dirty dozens, which are also a part of the pathophysiology. So the bottom line is multiple pathophysiological features are involved in type 2 diabetes. So targeting one pathophysiology is never enough. So you see, way back in 2017, there are 488 drugs which were licensed for type 2 diabetes. Despite that, estimated future years of life loss due to diabetes is tremendous. So after having so many drugs also, the mortalities and morbidities in diabetic patients are sky high. We all know about the natural history of diabetes, how a patient becomes persistent hyperglycemic from a normal glycemic state. That is definitely because of the beta cell decline, which is progressive in nature. Colossal beta cell loss starts much, and I repeat, much earlier than overt hyperglycemia. This is all about the mechanism of death of beta cells from the textbook of diabetes. And we all are aware of the fact that overt type 2 diabetes is diagnosed when at least 50% beta cell loss has taken place. Beautifully demonstrated from the UKPDS slide you can see on the right-hand side, where beta cell function continues to decline regardless of interventions in type 2 diabetes. There was a wonderful study done by Dr. Bernardo et al. Way back in 2007. He wanted to see how much beta cell was lost at diagnosis. So he found out 50% cells were only normal at diagnosis of diabetes. And when they did a necropsy of the pancreas, to their surprise, 60% of beta cell mass was gone. And also this fact is supported by UKPDS progressive deterioration in beta cell function over time, as you can see in the slides. And despite or regardless of all interventions with agents, when you follow up the patients for 6 long years, the declination remains same. So my dear friends from the opponent team, diabetes once diagnosed is a lifelong disorder, and you cannot get back beta cells from grave. Let me talk about a little bit about the remission, those points the opponents will raise. We all know about a direct diabetes remission trial. But then there is no consensus of the definition of remission. As you can see here, A1C below 6.5, discontinuation of diabetic medication for 2 months. Some other group saying A1C below 5.7, discontinuation of diabetic medication for 1 year. And still some group saying that the patient is taking metformin and A1C below 6.5, you can term it as remission. So why so much of confusion? So there is no consensus of remission and it's a mirage. On top of that, to add to our confusion, short-term remission, long-term remission, remission is confused with reversal, all those things are there. So let me clear up the cloud. To quote the Oxford English Dictionary, what remission stands for, what the definition of remission is, it's a period during which a serious illness improves for a time and the patient seems to get better, he's not better. Whereas reversal is a change of something so that it is opposite of what it was. So it is clear that remission and reversals are not the same things. Let me talk about pre-diabetes. Lifestyle modification may bring remission to pre-diabetic state, lowering insulin resistance, better glycemic control. But is it reversal of diabetes? Definitely not. So remission is often confused with reversal of diabetes state. So glycemic normalization of diabetic person is not equivalent to reversal of diabetes. As of now, reversal of diabetes is a myth. So my opponents, don't fall play. It's a total no, no, and no. So if you tell at today's date that reversal is possible, totally in diabetic, all those type of diabetes, it will be the joke of the day, my dear friends. So don't try to temper the ball by saying that bariatric surgeries, whether it is RYGB or sleeve gastrectomy, low calorie diet or low carbohydrate diet can reverse diabetes, because reversal of diabetes is still in experimental stage and in animal models. All approved modalities are claiming reduction of obesity and glycemia, and thus remission of diabetes is not reversal. Reversal of diabetes is not possible. A little bit about the bariatric surgeries you'll be talking about. My master blaster, Dr. Medhi, will be taking up more about bariatric surgeries, but let me just touch that bariatric surgery is approved for patients above BMI of 40 or BMI of 30 with obesity-related complications. So how many percentage of your patients fall in this criteria? I am not talking about the cost involved at all. So low-calorie diet and low-carbohydrate diet is not sustainable and practically feasible in most of our patients. We all know that. And let me just prove this statement that I have given by these two slides. So I say to my opinion, don't build castle in the air. You see what happens when you do surgeries and intervene with LCD and LC. First year looks very green, but when you follow up those patients for long duration of time, the patient relapses. If you talk about HbA1c, all you are talking about weight, the same thing happens. Few points like regeneration of beta cell experiments are not encouraging. Future will only tell what will happen, but as of now, reversal of diabetes is not possible. Reversal of diabetes, my friend, is a myth. Today's topic is reversal, by the way. So why we are talking only about type 2 diabetes? What about type 1 diabetes, LADA, MODY, FCPD, GDM, and other types? Are you going to reverse those also with bariatric surgery? Definitely not. So at last, I would like to state that hope is what keeps us alive, but in pursuit of hope, don't we ignore the reality. Me and my team strongly believes that reversal of diabetes is nothing but a monstrous myth. So dance be who, stay cool, don't take tension. And at last, I would like to offer a hot cup of blue tea from Assam to my opponents, because they will need those. Thank you so much for your patient hearing. This is Dr. Rupam signing off.
Great. You that finished on time.
7 minutes. Yes. That was 7 minutes, 11 seconds. So that 1 minute can go to your next speaker if needed.
Yeah. Who is your second speaker? Hello, good evening, everyone. As my previous speaker has already told a lot about the reversal of diabetes, it's a myth. I fully agree with him, and I'll try to make it more of a reality. So I'd just like to proceed with the definition of remission and reversal of diabetes. Reversal can be defined as the restoration to good health,
Remission is defined as abatement or disappearance of signs and symptoms of a disease. For a chronic illness like diabetes, it is more accurate to use the term remission than reversal. And in remission, we have complete remission, we have prolonged remission. Complete remission is for the symptoms to return to normal value for 1 year without taking any medicines. And for prolonged, it is 5 years without taking any medicines. So don't you think that the terminology of reversal of diabetes is a misnomer? It's completely wrong. And we have, and this opening is, it's a no ball. Don't you agree with it? It's a no ball. And not only it's a no ball, my opponent is getting stumped also in the very first over. So as I proceed with natural history of diabetes, which you all know that as the time passes, the insulin decreases, the insulin resistance remains the same, and the beta cells also decreases. And you all know this slide. You all must have seen this slide many a time. This march of the beta cell towards death, I equate it to the death march which Hitler had in his concentration camp. And this death march is been accentuated by many factors like lipotoxicity, like glucotoxicity, like oxidative stress, inflammation, ingrain defects. So they all accentuate the problem. And this death march continues till the time the beta cells are totally abolished. So all the therapy which we are using, do any of it prevent this march or stop this march or reverse the march? Nothing. You all have been practicing diabetes for decades, and you know that these are all myth, that no drug which you are using as of now prevents the death march of these beta cells towards their doom. So if that is there, if we can't stop this march of the beta cell, then can you think of reversing diabetes? Completely wrong. Completely wrong. I would just like to proceed with few of the propositions which my opposition will have. They will try to harp upon diet modification, the exercise, the bariatric surgery. So I'd just like to highlight a few of this. Diet had been a cornerstone in the management of diabetes. I fully agree with it. But diet never reverses diabetes. Diet only controls diabetes. Because this famous study which is there, the DIRECT study, which was open label cluster randomized trial, multicenter, in which patients who were more than 6 years of diabetes of all age group who were obese were included in the study. And what was the outcome? Weight loss was seen in only 36% participants. And only 46% of participants had this remission of diabetes. So such a low percentage, only 46% had some positive effect. So we can say that the results are not at all encouraging. And why this diet and exercise are not an answer to reverse diabetes? Because we can say that diabetes is not a disease that is caused by the lack of exercise. The underlying problem is excessive dietary glucose and fructose causing hyperinsulinemia, not lack of exercise. Exercise can improve insulin resistance only in the muscles. It does not improve insulin resistance in the liver. So reversing of type 2 diabetes depends upon treating the root cause, which is beta cell dysfunction. So don't you think I deserve a 4 for this? Of course, it's a boundary. So this is about the bariatric surgery. When bariatric surgery came out, a lot of hue and cry was there. The surgeons almost snatched the treatment of diabetes from the physicians. We thought that now it has become a surgeon's game, but everything has got its own limitations. And this study, which came out in Diabetes Care just in March 2020, what did they found? They found that bariatric surgery only causes transient remission. It doesn't cause reversal. Although we can say remission of type 2 diabetes with bariatric surgery, reversal is not possible because it has been seen that in 5 years' time, only 35% of patients stay in remission, and that number decreases as the time progresses. But the old hats, they are not going to leave it. How can they earn some hard money if they still say that bariatric surgery is not a answer to diabetes? So what they are saying now? Now they are saying that although we can't reverse diabetes, a statistical significant improvement in glycemic control, number of diabetes medication decreases, including insulin, blood pressure improves, lipid profile also improves in the long run. So now they have climbed down from the days they were saying that, yes, we can reverse diabetes with bariatric surgery. Now they have climbed down to we can control diabetes better. So I think that is mellowing down. And I think they have realized the reality that diabetes can't be reversed. It can only be controlled in a better way. And bariatric surgery is not an answer to reversal of diabetes. So doesn't it qualify for a six? Of course, it's a six, and that is how we call it a six. Now let's discuss some drugs which you use in the management of beta cells. All these years, these pharma giants had been pondering us, had been pressuring us that whatever drugs come out, they always say that this drug does something good for the beta cell. You all know, you all have been practicing diabetes, but you all know that what drug does what. Some drug decreases the glucotoxicity, some drug decreases lipotoxicity, some drug improves insulin resistance, some drug causes decrease in the oxidative stress, but no drug causes the death march of beta cell to stop or reverse. We are just playing into the hands of the pharma giants by claiming that all this drug does wonder to the beta cell. No, no drugs does wonder to the beta cell, and no one can reverse the death of the beta cell, or no one can do anything good for the beta cell. So the poor beta cell goes down the drain and the death march continues. But my opponents will always say about insulin and incretin therapy. So I'll just lay some points on insulin. Insulin, we all know that it is a major player in the fight against diabetes. And many studies have shown that insulin improves the life of the beta cell by means of its effect on the FOXO protein. The FOXO protein is a protein which is found in the nucleus on the cytoplasm, and it is a metabolic switch which switches the metabolism of the cell during acute stress between glucose and fatty acid. But we all know that these are all research-oriented. Mainly, FOXO protein came into being after the famous Banting lecture of 2017, and it was highlighted from them. But we all know that in our generation, and not only our generation, our next generation is also not going to see.
So 1 minute. Any drug which can
affect the beta cells. So FOXO protein is a myth. It's like building a castle in the air. And insulin, this famous Chinese trial, they have shown that it can only cause remission in 56% of patients. And that too with lower HbA1c, better beta cell function at baseline, and shorter duration of diabetes. So again, it's a boundary for me. So incretin therapy, a lot of hue and cry has been made. But also, it's a failure. This slide you must have seen many a time, and you must have also presented it many a times. But the caveat is, all this therapy works only till the time GLP is being infused. Moment GLP is stopped, all these so-called miracles disappear. So the question is, are we reviving the beta cells or reversing diabetes? It is for all of you to ponder. And a perfect six for me, I think. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you for finishing our time. Good. So, Dr. Archana, you can invite the opposite team.
Yes. So, we have the Assam Avengers already, and now we have the Andhra Artisans. Very exciting. Can we have the captain, please?
Yeah, I think before we go to the captain, maybe they would want to show a slide. Yes, here we are.
Yeah.
Tarigidum,
Anand, I think I would like to say here, while the Bihu dance will get rid of your frozen shoulder and improve your ankylosing spondylitis, I'm sure the Kuchipudi dance will improve your hip and your knee joint. Don't you agree?
Absolutely, sir. And they're also not the static position also improve the cervical and lumbar spondylosis.
Excellent. So now we have had the tea. Now we are going to taste the biryani. So over biryani. To Dr. Sharda.
Yes.
Before that, I may just inform all of our friends that more than 2,000 our friends have linked to this match. Over to you, Archana.
Can we have the captain of Andhra Artisans now?
Dr. G.R. Sridhar.
Dr. Sridhar.
Yes. Good evening. It's a delightful day. Just on this very day, October 23rd, 1988, when I was inducted into the Indian team, I started my center on this day. And 32 years later, I've been presented with an excellent team, a balance of youth and experience. The first batsman or the bats person, if you would like to say, is Dr. Aishwarya. She's a fresh DM. And she knows all what all of us should be knowing. She finished it recently. When I said you have to speak for 8 minutes, she was quite worried. I said, what is there? Speak for 8 minutes. She said, no, sir. I have so much to speak and I need more time to forget so that I can just put in the information in just 8 minutes. I think you can be quite happy because your opponents have helped you out. What you wanted to say, they have already said. They wanted to show it's a half empty glass, but what they showed is the glass is filling up. So you just have to help them out from their confusion and say why what they are thinking is bad is correct. And second, we have an experienced Dr. Ram Kumar. He is unique in the sense I don't think there's anybody else like that in the whole of India. We tell the people or patients to be happy, but he does it. So he has been running a cartoon contest for many years. And these cartoons depict only about diabetes. So he holds it every year and he gives awards every year. And I left the best for the last, Dr. Jawahar. Again, he's a man of action. I and many of us keep saying that we should educate the patients. Dr. Jawahar doesn't speak, he educates them. And compared to most of us, he's the one who will be always in front of a computer screen for a webinar or on a platform, educating the specialist general physicians, as well as the general public for learning about diabetes and how to deal with this. So it's a mix of experience and youth, and we'll see how they are going to respond to this. Assam, it's a beautiful place. It's got a Mail River flowing into the Bay of Bengal. And it so happens that I stay just next door to the Bay of Bengal. So all what the water is there is going to flow down to it. And we'll see how our team is going to deal with the so-called bouncers, which are more of slow balls for our brilliant players. We start off with Dr. Aishwarya.
Can I start?
Yes.
Please start.
Thank you. The reversal of diabetes. So our rivals from Assam have asked these questions. Is it possible and is it doable? But the answer is yes. And before I proceed, it is important to note that reversal is not cure. There are many shades to it. It can be complete normalcy without any further interventions, complete normalcy with lifestyle and healthy interventions, or a march towards normalcy, being getting closer towards normalcy. So even if you have lost your watch and found it, you must still take care that it isn't lost another time. So when we have a patient with type 2 diabetes mellitus, we have been traditionally tuned to start off the patient with pharmacological therapy. But fasting, the voluntary abstinence from food, has been known to cure diabetes, which has been thoroughly researched and observed by Elliot P. Jocelyn as early as 1970. So when you see the pathogenesis of diabetes mellitus, apart from the genetic factors, the other risk factors such as the physical inactivity, obesity, and environmental factors also playing their role, contributing to these risk factors, and the intake of excess calories do play a major role in the pathogenesis of type 2 diabetes mellitus. So when we see the diabetes prevention studies, the Finnish diabetes prevention study and the reduction in incidence of type 2 diabetes with lifestyle intervention by the Diabetes Prevention Program Research Group. So they found that with the lifestyle intervention itself, the patients with impaired glucose tolerance, they could reverse their condition and as well as maintain normal glycemia for a prolonged period. So this got our researchers thinking that the diet might be a major contributor to this. So why don't we just shut this off? So based on this, the study done by Dr. Lim et al., reversal of type 2 diabetes, as we can see in the figures, the return of normal beta cell insulin secretion was within a few weeks, and it was in step with the fall in the pancreas fat. And the index case remained normoglycemic to 14 years after stopping glucose-lowering therapies. Even he was diagnosed for 4 years of type 2 diabetes with type 2 diabetes mellitus. So as already mentioned by Dr. S.R. Arvind, the twin cycle hypothesis have shown that patients who have the positive calorie balance leads to increased accumulation of fat in the liver, thereby leading to the resistance to insulin suppression of glucose production in the level of the hepatic system, resulting in increased endogenous glucose production. And this fat is again transferred to the pancreas via the VLDL, thereby increasing the islet triglycerides and resulting in a reduced insulin response to the ingested glucose. So this is the phase where the beta cells lose their capacity to increase the insulin response towards the increased blood sugar levels. So this leads to hyperglycemia and type 2 diabetes mellitus. So when very low calorie diet was introduced to these patients, they found that after substantial weight loss, the isocaloric balance has led to the normalization of the liver fat content, thereby able to achieve a normal insulin sensitivity and control of glucose production by the liver, reducing the endogenous glucose production. So similarly, the transport of the fat towards the pancreas has been reduced, and the reduced islet triglycerides has led to normalization of the insulin response to the ingested glucose at the level of the pancreas. So this is the phase where the beta cells were able to regain their capacity, regenerate, and was able to increase the insulin response and maintain normoglycemia. And based on this concept, a number of studies have been done, a few of which are very important are the 6 weeks and 12 weeks of calorie restriction. They found that when you see the results, it's drastic. And the results also show that the reduction in the fasting glucose and triacylglycerol have been prolonged for over a period of 2 years. And 6 weeks of calorie restriction itself, the acute negative balance itself had lowered the fasting plasma glucose and the endogenous glucose production, but accompanying improvement in the beta cell function, which was observed to be prolonged. This effect was prolonged for about 2 years. Then the direct study, thanks to the Assam rivals who have already mentioned that they saw this study from only one point of view, they didn't see it from the other point. So this is an open label randomized trial done across 49 centers where they introduced the intensive weight management. And they found that by the end of 1 year, about 24% of the patients in their intervention group achieved more than 15 kg weight loss. And it was found that close to 50% of the patient could achieve remission of their type 2 diabetes mellitus status by the end of 1 year. And the remission was directly proportional to the weight loss in these groups. then the counterpoint study, we can see that the negative balance, there's a drastic fall in the and the result in the fasting plasma glucose levels, and the resolution of the hepatic insulin sensitivity was found within a few days of the start of on the low calorie diets. It was associated with a rapid fall in the liver fat levels and normalization of the fasting glucose levels. Similarly, the pancreas fat content was also observed to decrease, and the first phase insulin response has gradually increased and had normalized by 8 weeks. Then our Indian study done by Dr. Unnikrishnan et al, they wanted to evaluate the effect of a low calorie diet on restoration of normoglycemia in obese subjects with type 2 diabetes. They also found very positive and promising results, where almost 50% of the subjects could achieve their HbA1c levels in the non-diabetic range with the low calorie diets, despite stopping all the anti-diabetic medications, and also found improvement in the OMA-IR and the QIKI indices for the insulin resistance. Unfortunately, our rivals didn't believe in this concept, but fortunately, American Diabetes Association believes in this concept, and they are the ones who termed the coins the partial, complete, and prolonged remission, where the partial remission has been defined as the having blood sugar levels that do not meet the criteria for type 2 diabetes classification for at least 1 year while not taking any medications to lower the blood glucose. Complete remission has been defined as a return to normal glucose levels for at least 1 year without taking any medications.
One minute, Dr. Shwarya.
Yes. The return to normal glucose levels for at least 5 years without taking any medications. And other international bodies such as the Association of British Clinical Diabetologists and the Primary Care Diabetes Society has released a consensus statement like supporting this evidence, and also recommends a set guidelines for us to follow in order to achieve remission of type 2 diabetes mellitus. So colleagues, it's time for us to make remission a reality, especially in our country with our diets containing a very high carbohydrate content, and most of the people finances are a concern. So it's better to make remission or reversal in our patients, and also try for prevention of type 2 diabetes mellitus. Thank you.
Thank you for finishing in time. We can have your second player.
Sir, can I share my screen?
Please.
Thank you. Good evening, everyone. I will discuss what are the other ways for getting remission or reversal in diabetes. And this is an elephant. We are going to tame this elephant of diabetes with our artisan. We are artisans, so we will try to tame this. And I want to mention about the high rates of diabetes reversal in newly diagnosed Asian Indian young adults with type 2 diabetes mellitus with intensive lifestyle therapy. Why this study is important? Because it is done in young people who are around 40 years and who develop. I feel in this study is very important, because if a young person develops diabetes, we should protect him for more than 50 years to prevent complications. If we can achieve remission in these patients, that will be very helpful to them in the long run. So this study is a prospective study, includes 32 patients with newly diagnosed type 2 diabetes. They were initially treated with intensive lifestyle therapy, HbA1c below 9 treated with lifestyle, HbA1c above 9 were given metformin. And the results are amazing. Reversal or remission rates at 3 months, 1 year and 2 years were 24, 24 and 22. They are almost similar. And 17 patients achieved complete reversal and 7 patients achieved partial reversal at 3 months. Rates of complete and partial remission at 1 year were 50% and 25% and at 2 years were 46.9% and 21.9% respectively. Even remission of 2 years is very useful because patient will be free from tablets and other injections. And another study is piloting remission strategy in type 2 diabetes, results of a randomized control trial. And this is published in Journal of Clinical Endocrinology. And participants were randomized into 8-week intensive metabolic intervention or a 16-week intensive metabolic intervention or standard diabetes care. During the intervention period, weight loss and normoglycemia were targeted using lifestyle approaches and treatment with metformin, acarbose, and insulin glargine. They did it intensively. Diabetes drugs were discontinued and intervention groups and participants were followed for hyperglycemic relapse. And at 8 weeks, 50% of the 8-week intervention group versus 3.6% of the controls achieved normoglycemia, and 40.7% of the 16-week group compared with 14.3% met hemoglobin A1C criteria for complete or partial diabetes remission. These studies, two studies, indicate that not only diet, we can use pharmacotherapy to achieve remission. And insulin therapy, when they use it intensively at the diagnosis, that also leads to remission. It was a Chinese study. Okay, next coming to bariatric surgery and diabetes remission, who would have thought it? This is a review article done by our colleagues, A.K. Singh and Sunil Kumar. Bariatric surgery has been seen to associate with substantial and sustained weight loss in morbidly obese patients. Interestingly, bariatric surgeries also induce higher rates of short and long-term diabetes remission. Although the exact mechanism behind this diabetes remission are not well understood, improved insulin action, beta cell function, and complex interplay of hormones in the enteroinsular axis appears to play a major role. If diet and exercise fail, we have to go for bariatric surgery. So principally, bariatric surgeries can be of three types: restrictive procedures, malabsorption procedures, and mixed procedures. RYBG is currently the gold standard technique, but recently some studies have also highlighted the use of ileal interposition as a novel mode of remission in diabetes. And I will be discussing about Swedish obese subject study, where 64% of patients in surgical arm, they compared surgical and routine medical therapy. What they found out that 64% of patients in surgical arm, 15% in the medical arm experienced diabetes remission, and gastric obstruction yielded 60% and gastric diversion gave 76% remission, which was very predictable. And what are the mechanisms, potential mechanisms contributing to improved glycemic control? These are the various mechanisms you may be knowing. Okay, these are the randomized control trial. This is evidence because it's not a randomized control trial. And they say every trial clearly says that bariatric surgery gives remission in Australia, Italy, USA, everywhere. And they all are having significant results. And in the future, I think artificial intelligence and machine learning will also give us an opportunity to learn more about diabetes remission. And I think it is not a dream, but it will be a reality. Because we achieved so many nice things in the science, I hope we will do it in the future. And I want to conclude that we have to prevent diabetes in the primary level itself, as shown by diabetes prevention program in US and Indian diabetes prevention program in India. If we can't prevent, then prevent if you can cure, prevent if you can, and cure if you must. If we focus treatment modality for a remission, we can do it. Nothing is impossible. The word itself says, I am possible. As Ashwa told by our legend, if we give more chance to our patients for remission, we will improve and definitely we will get a remission. Thank you very much. I am done.
Good. Thank you for finishing.
That was well in time.
Yeah. Ma'am, can I add one more slide? Just one more.
Yes, yes. You have 20 seconds.
Yes. And I want to tell people in Assam, our colleagues, 26,603 people speak Telugu in Assam. We are very related. We drink your tea, you eat our fish. Both are useful in diabetes remission. Assamese say Dhanyavad and we say Dhanyavad to team RSSDA. And this is our photo of Bansi Saab. This photo was shown in a meeting and everybody is asking who is the man beside Bansi. So Bansi is so popular and I thank Bansi for giving this and he's reactivated RSSDA. Thank you very much, Bansi and your team. Good night.
Beautiful words given, but correct words are given by our speaker. And both the teams have put forward so many scientific facts. So it is a very difficult decision for us to decide. So I think now we will go for rebuttal. Dr. Archana?
Yes, over to Assam Avengers for their rebuttal. Who is coming on the crease?
Yeah, this is Dr. Ripul. But am I audible to you all?
Yes.
Yeah, my time starts now.
Yes, you have 3 minutes.
Okay, fine. Thank you. The respected legends of the game, commentators and umpires, ladies and gentlemen, I shall be brief and in bullet points. At the very outset, I take this opportunity to thank our opponents for huge amount of nose and wise they have thrown upon us. I would like to say, Dr. Osoja, we are not rivals. We are just believers in the opposite way. Having said that, Mr. Ampers, the motion of the house is reversal of diabetes, not just a mere remission, which is a temporary phenomenon as clearly and precisely depicted by our speakers. And that to the diabetes reversal, not only type 2 diabetes, and all the data and studies have so far shown so far the points towards remission only. And mind that this is not just a single, there is not a single follow-up study beyond 2 years. How can you say it's a reversal is possible? To me, ladies and gentlemen, diabetes and an illegal pregnancy has got something in common. One is conceived with pleasurable activity, super activity, you can say. The other is conceived by absolute or relative physical inactivity. But then that pregnancy has got to be one father. You can really find it out who is the culprit, illegal pregnancy. But in diabetes, the multiple fathers, right from triumvirate to ominous octave, 30 dozen, and so many fathers to come to claim the fathership, who knows? But say that if you at all want to reverse diabetes, tell me that. Which father you are going to nullify? Tell me that. Mr. Ampers, just imagine, you are talking remission only, just imagine a patient with remission for a few months to years with that half-cut stomach, all those dumping syndrome and complications of rots and shoulder gastrectomy. For everyone, or say in low-calorie diet or in low-carbohydrate diet regime or exercise regularly, for every moment he has to ask his doctor, doctor, can I do this? Can I do that? Can I have a piece of pizza, please, tonight? Can I go with my girlfriend for a dating tonight? So that's why I want to say that we are transforming a normal individual into just a robotic material with the remote switch in the hands of the diabetologist, in the hands of the physician, and in the hands of and the surgeon. So this is what I want to say in the last, my dear friends, Mr. Ampers, with all those respected seniors. If they can reverse diabetes, I'm talking about my opponents, if they can reverse diabetes without an intervention, I am sure, 100% sure, they can reverse a pregnancy without any intervention. Thanks. This is my ending. Thanks. In no way I can believe that diabetes is possible. Tar lagile moi jan brahmin manu logune sikok bamunei morok. I cannot believe. Just imagine what I want to say. Logune sikok bamunei morok. I cannot believe it. This is absolutely a myth, diabetic reversal. Absolutely a myth only. Thank you so much.
We can go to the next team for their rebuttal.
Good
Dr. Sridhar, you have to unmute.
No, Dr. Jawahar will be doing the honors. Jawahar, are you online?
Respected dignitaries and dear delegates, so it's my pleasure to say that the reversal of the diabetes is a big reality, because diabetes is a lifestyle disease. Diabetes, even though you say that omnia soctate or the dirty dozen causes, all the causes can be reversible with a one single drug called medical nutrition therapy. If you see the reduction of the HbA1c next to the insulin, it is a medical nutrition therapy which reduces the HbA1c to the tune of about 2 to 2.5%. What you mean by the medical nutrition therapy? It is a low carbohydrate, low calorie, no trans fats, low saturated fat, more unsaturated fats, more fiber, more potassium, except in the CKD population, and low sodium. So if you stick on do this, definitely we can reduce the insulin resistance to a big extent. In India, it is the insulin resistance which is more common rather than the insulin deficiency. Even with the medical nutrition therapy, you can improve the insulin sensitivity and you can improve the entry of the insulin to the muscle and the adipose tissue so that you can control the diabetes in a much better way. Why you are all worrying about the diabetes? Not because of its complications. The more the complications, more the mortality. All the complications are directly proportional to your A1C levels. So definitely with the good dietary approach and with the exercise approach, definitely we can reduce the HbA1c to the tune of 6.5 or the 7. And about the word about the pre-diabetes, so even though we give a lot of importance to the diabetes, in India, equal number of the pre-diabetic patients are there. So all the pre-diabetic patients will be the future diabetics unless you advise them the reversal of these pre-diabetes. So the reversal of the pre-diabetes is available, is possible only with your medical nutrition therapy or in some people with the metformin. So what about the LADA, DM1 and GDM? So they hardly place about only 5 to 15% of the Indian population. So most of the Indian diabetics are the type 2 diabetics. And Dr. Sanjeev said that control is not possible with the diabetes. See, the control is possible and control is as good as the cure. Because if you control the diabetes, and definitely we control all the complications and also all the vascular diseases associated with the diabetes. I conclude here. Thank you very much for your patient hearing.
Thank you. Thank you for finishing in time. So, Dr. Archana, there is two the terms stuff. Which are very commonly used, reversal and
Yes. So I think we can have everyone here.
To the umpires, that nobody has asked for review.
Yes, nobody has asked for review.
Assam and Andhra Pradesh. Kalyanda, you have to ask Kalyanda. For reviews as well.
Kalyanda, can we ask our coaches, the team coaches, how their team has done?
Let us ask them. While the team prepares for their review question, let us ask the team coaches. Yeah.
I think we asked Dr. Santosh Adhikari from Assam Avengers. Dr. Santosh Adhikari, are you there?
Yes. Good evening to everyone.
Good evening, sir. How are your team has done today's match?
Fantastic. And they have already won it. Because my opponent team, what they were making a mixture of remission and reversal. Remember, go to the point. What was the theme? It was the reversal of diabetes. It is a myth. And they have indirectly surrendered to this. It is they have said these many remissions are possible for these many years, diet and exercise, with lifestyle modification, with bariatric surgery, and so what? Indirectly, they have said that reversal is not possible. Remission is only the reality. And that has been proved and everybody has listened to it. And I have nothing to say more. And I am sure my team has already won the battle.
But sir, I think the opening batswoman from the Andhra has made some very comprehensive what your points on that.
Yes.
How you counter those things?
Those points, again they are coming to the again definition, no? The reversal, short time reversal, long, prolonged reversal, like that. There is actually no cure cut. If you go to the dictionary meaning of reversal, that is the situation when the disease, the person will be disease free without taking medication. Lifestyle is allowed, but without taking medication. And they have pointed out one study where they have said that with metformin reversal, can it be a reversal when you are taking a drug along with lifestyle?
Very
hard to understand. At least I don't understand.
Kalyanda, can we ask some question from Dr. S. Sadasiv Rao?
Yeah, Dr. Sadasiv Rao, you are the coach of the Andhra team. Now the Assam coach has almost come into the field to fight with you.
Yes, Santosh. See, his mindset is not changed. See, we should change your mindset at every information that we get and try to, as healthcare providers, try to give better options to our patients. And I practice that, and I have seen a massive reduction in the weight of our patients, and thereby they're getting rid of diabetes also. I've practically seen that, and they stopped taking tablets, and there was a remission. So I think our team has done well, and they have set their points. And I don't agree that it's a myth or it's a reality. So we have to see the facts, and also as a poor nation, and many of people cannot afford the costly medicines. And so we should practice what we preach and say, tell them that first thing is diet, and then lifestyle changes. That's very important because they don't cost us much money. They don't cost us anything. So I think most of our people, we should counsel them and tell them that try to practice lifestyle and diet, which is very important in the treatment of, which is a cornerstone in the treatment of diabetes. After that, only other managements or pharmacotherapy comes into.
So Dr. An Sarkar, next time you go to Andhra Pradesh, you will not get any biryani.
Yes, sir. How I will enjoy Andhra. Without biryani, Andhra is, I think, it's a dry like Bihar.
Okay, so umpires, can you ask the teams again for review if they are going for a review? Mm-hmm. I think the crowd is getting restless. They are waiting for the review question.
Hello, I am Dr. P.K. Biswas. I want to take a review from Assam.
Please go ahead.
I want to have a review.
Sir, please go ahead with your question, sir. The umpires are listening to you, sir.
Yes, the review question, please.
Our teammate will come and he will give. Dr. Sanjay, please tell
us. I have a review. I have some very important points which Andhra are trying to harp upon. They are saying about the diet and bariatric surgery, which are total misnomer. Well, how the diet which they are saying is a low-calorie diet. How long can a patient sustain himself on a low-calorie diet? 1 year, 2 years. Studies have shown that the diet always fails in the long run because the compliance is poor. So diet can never reverse diabetes. Second, bariatric surgery.
Wait, sir. Only one review is allowed, sir. Only one review is allowed.
Anand, while Dr. Medhi was talking, I could recollect from memory when Joel Garner used to come, you know, the West Indian bowler, 6'6", steaming in, and very scary, the batsmen almost lost their bat. So the way Dr. Sanjeev Medhi talked, I think, Andhra Pradesh, have you lost your bat or is bat still in your hand? If you have got the review, raise your bat up.
I think the VVS Lakshan is coming back, sir.
No point.
Yes, we'll do it.
Where is Lakshman?
No batsman can save them now.
You can change your mindset. You cannot change the dictionary. You can change your mindset, but you cannot change the dictionary.
Okay, umpires, can you ask Andhra Pradesh for the
Andhra don't have any batsmen to bat. Yes. With Dr. the Hooghly, which I have thrown.
Dr. Ram Kumar wants
Dr. Ram Kumar is making a point.
Dr. Ram Kumar is making a point. Yeah, over to you, Dr. Ram Kumar.
Sir, first I want to make a... review, sir, because your colleagues told that the cut point for BMI for a bariatric surgery is 45, but it's now 35. It's reduced. That is the first wrong. Another thing is there are studies which has clearly shown that after bariatric surgery, remission is feasible up to 8.3 years, almost 10 years. 8.3 years, I have, if you want, I will give reference also. And another thing is, if you can
give a... three questions. We are allowed only one review. He has been given three reviews.
I'm just answering.
I was stopped after one review. He is going to the third review also.
I want to answer. I want to answer his query, if I'm allowed.
Empire, sir. Go ahead.
Because he's talking about my slide, sir. So I would like to answer. Yes, sir, what I've shown in my slide is bariatric surgery is indicated above 40 or above 30 with obesity-related complications. This is from the textbook, and I don't know from where you got above 35. So that's what I wanted to say.
I think the opponents played the fast bowlers like spinners, you know, the captain. It's the wrong coaching.
Okay. So now over to you, umpires. What are you going to do now?
This is really tough with both the parties, both the sides really geared up and so much science. I think we have our legend with us, and a very short super over will settle the deal. So, Dr. Arvind, over to you.
Thank you, Archana. I think it was a very, very difficult decision to make, because the basic controversy started with the words reversal and remission. Okay, very technically, if I have to go to the Supreme Court and then argue out with the lawyers, they may say that, well, there is a difference. And Rupam also made sure that none of us looked at the Oxford Dictionary to understand the difference between reversal and remission. So very technically, I think Assam was right. They argued for reversal, okay? And they say it is not possible. Okay, now I haven't finished yet. But in the context of diabetes, when all of us speak, you know, it's generally these two words, reversal and remission, is often used synonymously, okay? Going by that count, I think Aishwarya's slides and the scientific content was brilliant to tell us that the remission is actually possible. May not be possible in everybody, but certainly is possible in a good number of people. And we have to give an option if the patient prefers to follow a low-calorie diet or a low-carb diet or a bariatric surgery or whatever it is. But since we cannot decide on that in the confusion, we will have a super over. Does it mean that there's going to be a question now, Archana?
Yes, sir. Please ask a question. Whatever you feel will be the deciding question.
Okay.
We'll give them now, 2 minutes each.
Each of you will get 2 minutes. It's impromptu. So who will speak for Assam right away? We need to know.
Dr. Sanjeev Medhi.
Sanjeev Medhi will speak for Assam. Who will speak for Andhra?
No batsman.
No. Who?
Jawahar, will you take it?
Yes, sir.
Fine, Dr. Jawahar.
Jawahar will take it. Okay. Sanjeev and Jawahar. See, since Assam batted first, now the first batting goes to Andhra in this super over. Jawahar, you will be speaking. It's a very, very simple question. Most of the studies have clearly shown the HbA1c reduction is the same when you use analogs and human insulin. Still, do we need short-acting analogs and analog mixtures in India?
Yes, sir. We need it because even though the HbA1c reduction is the same with the both, but as far as the pharmacokinetics and the pharmacodynamics are concerned, the analogs are much superior for the two reasons. One is the chances of the hypoglycemia are very less with the analogs, and also the weight gain with the analogs is also very less with the analogs. And you need not wait for about 30 minutes or the 45 minutes for between the insulin and the food intake with the regular insulins. Whereas for the analogs, you need not wait for the time being. So these three are very important points towards the analogs when compared to the regular insulins. But the cost factor is there. But for those people who can afford, and definitely we can go for the analogs when compared to the regular insulins.
Okay, thanks for completing it. Record time. I think now we move to Sanjeev Medhi. Unmute, please, before you start speaking.
Yes, sir.
Dr. Arvind, you unmute yourself, please.
Unmute. Dr. Arvind, unmute.
Yeah. Sanjeev, you speak on the same topic.
Sir, India is a country where we take a lot of carbohydrates and our blood sugar shoots up a lot. So, and it comes down also very fast. So analogs, although we are a developing country, our purchasing power is less, but still, if you leave that apart, analogs suits the Indian condition. Because the blood sugar, which shoots up first, is taken care of by the analog. And also the hypoglycemia, which occurs in the later part, if you don't take analog, which also taken care of by this analog insulins. So analogs brings down the hypoglycemia, brings down the postprandial sugar. And it is almost all, although man is trying to mimic the God's insulin, but we can never mimic God's insulin, but at least we are trying to go near the natural insulin. And we have been successful to quite a long because of these changes in the insulin therapy, which is going on. This is all I have to say. Thank you, sir.
Okay, now I think it's over to the umpires to decide who spoke best when it came to analogs, useful of analogs. I will leave it to the umpires. As a legend, I'm not supposed to take any part.
Dr. Sharma?
What we are going to do, just a minute, Dr. Archana and Dr. S.K. Sharma, we are going to have again the poll. It is the audience poll. And the results I am going to show, because you have done already, the match is over. You have done the super over also. But in between, till the match is going, the poll is going on, till that you can have discussion. There is a lot of confusion between the remission and reversal. So I would ask all the experts to comment on it. So first, both empires, and you can take both the third empire also. Along with, there are some experts like Dr. Brismakar wants to make some comments. And if anybody else is also there, they can make the comment.
Sir, can we give a comment also now? Because the match is over.
And Dr. Brismakar.
Let's take the comment out.
Thank you, Bansi. I think this was a very interesting debate. And interesting part was that, as always, the confusion was between reversal and remission. Now, most of the time, the reversal and remission definitions are very close, zones in between. Second thing is, now we are getting data at cellular level also that the reversal is possible. Now, how long? Important thing is, once we say reversal, we have to define, is it indefinite? We don't have any way of defining that there is an indefinite reversal of diabetes and it will never come again. And it is unlikely it will never come again because there is some genetic predisposition also involved, which will keep you predisposed to diabetes. But at cellular level, we know that there is cellular dedifferentiation, conversion of beta to alpha and alpha to beta, and role of metabolic flexibility and so many things happening. So it is very difficult to define or dissect between remission and reversal. But I think both the teams did a very good job. And I feel personally, this is my viewpoint, that Assam did a very good job, especially Rupam. Despite having no data to speak against reversal, he spoke very well against reversal.
Thank you, Dr. Makkad, for your comment. Dear friends, as Dr. Makkad highlighted, that both the teams have done great job. And earlier, we used to say that diabetes is a progressive disease. But now, with this point and counterpoint, we say that reversal and, of course, remission is possible. May not be too large number of our patients, but it is the idea and we should go for it.
And just one more point to add.
Other friend to unmute.
Just please. One more point to add. Yeah. Batting on a bad pitch is, very difficult. And Assam started with batting on a bad pitch.
Yeah, absolutely. All right. Bilkul. You are right that there are very great scientific, you can say, for the Andhra Pradesh, but not Assam.
I think we have a very esteemed panel here. Anyone else wishes to have any opinions, comments on the topic before we...
Dr. JJ, you want to make some comments?
Yes, please.
To see, to me, there is no confusion between remission and reversal. Remission is very obvious. It's a short term, maybe 6 months, 12 months, 24 months of remission in a disease. Reversal is completely different. Reversal is cure. Reversal means you have got diabetes cured. Now, all the data that I have been shown by the Andhra team, they've done a very good job. I really appreciate the way they presented their slides. They've done the research. It's all remission so far. So this was the whole point. You see, I think both should have fought on the remission and reversal.
KJ, how do you define cure in diabetes?
See, that is the question. That was the ADA thing which...
So there is no definition which can define cure.
See, to me, Bridge, we can have our debate.
There is a full debate on this itself.
We can have our debate here. See, cure means what? You have fever. The fever is gone. You have beta cell dysfunction.
Will it not come again? Will it not come again during the lifetime of the patient? That means cure.
No, so okay, I gave a wrong example. Fever is an
example. No, even diabetes. Okay, 5 years.
Chronic thing.
What is the cutoff line? 5 years, 10 years, 20 years. What is the cutoff line for cure?
I can give you a correct example of cure. Hair on the head of Srinivas Murthy, Dr. Arvind, and Sadashiv Rao. Cure. It's not going to come back.
Anand, there is something is happening in the stands. Look, yes, the crowd has started to fight with each other.
Yes, they are fighting, sir. They are fighting.
Doctor Sudeep wants to make some comment.
Yeah, although Anand, I am, you know, Anand, being a Bengali, as you know, Bengalis are fierce debaters. I am itching to make several comments, but I've kept myself shut. Because I'm the commentator, I will not speak a single word. But I'm enjoying the fight amongst the spectators. That's very good. Who else is going to speak out?
I will just request everyone to make comment only for 30 seconds.
I'm making a comment. I'm very happy that Assam... Hello. I'm very happy that Assam has really ignited a debate between remission and reversal. And that should be there. It shouldn't be taken for granted that remission is reversal. Two pumps are there, entirely different. And they've won it. But I'm having national history, but I think they've won it clearly. That debate has come today. Wonderful, wonderful, Assam.
Doctor,
can I speak?
Yes, Arvind.
There is a betting going on in Jaipur and other places in Dubai regarding the things. So the betting is very, very large now in the crores and billions. I don't know. Dr. Bansi.
Dr. Arvind Gupta, have you put your bet on somebody then?
Yeah. So Bansi, can you give the betting? Kisko jada ho raha hai?
Let us first take the comments. Dr. Sunil, you want to make some comments? Then Dr. Mithun Bharati also wants to make some comments.
See, this remission and reversal, I believe, let us think it from a patient perspective also. And how these terminologies are misused, we should be aware of. So people feel reversal means now they can eat anything, they can live like anything. That is how and I know that these things are being transmitted in a wrong way. So I believe till we understand it better, the terminology should be remission and not reversal.
Okay. Dr. Mithun Bharati, you want to make a comment? You have to unmute.
We can't hear you, Mithun.
We had the short straw, but the Assam team did extremely well. The important thing, all the trials, when we come to MNTs or very low calorie diets, they have shorter duration of action. The longer data is missing. But I think that's a very point that Sunil Jain sir has brought about. Is that it's a perspective from the patients as to what they think remission is and what they think a cure is. And I think remission from drugs is a better word rather than, or cure from drugs, but you still have diabetes, still on the fence, anything can tip you over, you need to maintain your lifestyle. I think that would be my two words.
So I think we are having an excellent discussion. And it's clear that both the teams have worked hard and they have presented in data in such a way that it has stimulated a lot of discussion amongst ourselves. And I think we should not just limit to who has done well and who has not done well. You have to take everything in perspective and just leave the debate out, as the last few points had highlighted. So anybody else who wants to say a few words?
I think we misuse or interchange these two words because of our incapability of actually reversing diabetes. I mean, chalo, 100 nahi, 85 le lete hain. Wohi wala funda hai. We think remission is reversal, which is not correct. I think we are not going to debate take our opponent to the Supreme Court. They should say yes to remission and not to to reversal.
Bansi, audience poll ka kya status hai?
Giving the audience poll only for within 1 minute.
Within 1 minute, so we have got time. On my screen, I can see Dr. Vijay Kumar as well, who has raised his finger up. Dr. Vijay Kumar, unmute yourself first.
I think, you know, let us not worry about remission and reversal or anything like that. As Dr. Sunil was telling that about the, you know, patient perspective, I think if you are able to have remission for even for a few years, that itself is going to be great. Leave alone reversal. The remission for a few years, if you can prevent diabetes during a short period, so it's 5 years or 10, if you don't have any data on that, there are no guidelines to say how long you should say to prevent it. So if you have a good glycemic control, normoglycemia, for a longer period, as long as period as possible, if we can prevent complications in the long run, we can have a good quality of life for the patients. So I think we should, I mean, for the benefit of the audience, in order to say that, I think let us not worry about remission and reversal. You should take methodologies so that remission itself is very good. Let us not worry about the reversal. That's what I would like to say.
Thank you. Sir, can I speak?
So everyone. No, yes. Sir,
I think it is already over. What we do is now, I'm
put
the umpires for declaring the result, and I will tell Hardik to show the results on the screen.
Yes, the audience poll results are out, and during the registration, they had said 74% of our audience had said that it is a reality, and 26 had said it was a myth. Now at the start of the event, it was 78 and 22, and at the end of this debate, our audience still believes that reversal is a reality. That is 76% and 24% believe it is a myth. Maybe some have changed from here or there.
No, but
some oranges have become
2% change, you know, from now there is a from 22 to 24. So I mean, there's a 2% increase was there.
Believe
for
that it,
is it
so their faith has shaken.
Significant?
2% people, their faith has shaken.
Yes,
but
less than 5%, you can't say who is the winner. Unless there is a more than 5% change is there, we can't say.
Yes.
Bansi, do we have the p-value? We have the p-value.
So this will become a tie then.
Yes, it is.
Yes.
Tie only. And I invite Sanjay for... Man of the Match to announce the name of Man of Match, because we don't have anyone who is winner, clear winner. Sanjay.
I think we are very proud to announce the Man of the Match, I would say Woman of the Match, Dr. Aishwarya. So a big clap to her for a wonderful presentation. She's clearly the best speaker of the day, and we are very happy to announce her name. Congratulations to you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Congratulations, Dr. Aishwarya.
Congrats.
Congratulations, Dr. Aishwarya.
Congratulations, Dr. Aishwarya.
Dr. Aishwarya, you want to speak for 10 seconds, you know, after a man of the match ceremony award,
you
speak for a few seconds. How are you feeling? What are you going to do with the money which Dr. Agarwal has given you just now?
And what are the data points you're going to highlight from here in your favor?
So, I would like to first tell that even though the patients were put on a very restricted diet with a very low calorie diet for a few weeks, the negative calorie balance is itself was sufficient that the patients were able to maintain, even though they were put on a maintenance diet for more than 6 months to 1 year period. So that was one of the questions raised by some of the colleagues. And I would say that, yes, India being a country where the staple diets have a high carbohydrate content, maybe with changes in our diet, we would be able to reverse many pre-diabetics and maybe able to take many diabetic patients into reversal or remission. Thank you.
So, Dr. S.R. Arvind had left.
No,
debate. The debate is that whether the reversal or remission, whatever you call, whether it is a myth or reality. Now, it is reality because there is a lot of randomized controlled trials are there, which is the paper from 2011 to 2018, and then the 17 paper, which had created a lot of hype all over the world, Roy Teller, and he talked that there is a possibility of remission. But why it is myth? Because myth, it is what he had used. If you know that for 5 months, he asked all his patients who were in the trial, he had given them 750 kilocalorie, which is again a formula-based diet. It was not even the diet. And then after 5 months, for next 2 years, they were supposed to take only 1,000 kilocalorie per day. And that too, out of that, 50% of that should not be, more than 50% of should not be from carbs, and which is really not possible in our day-to-day life. And that's the reason you can call it's a myth also. The second big problem is it cannot be for everyone, because the patients he has taken are less than 6 years of diabetes. They were not on insulin. So it means diabetes reversal is not possible for everyone. It is for a selected class of patients, only few patients who can be motivated, and then you can give them a choice of a reversal and remission. Why the Dr. Makkar was talking that why it can't be called as a cure, because he has done that first phase of insulin secretion can come back. And that was the first pathophysiological defect in type 2 diabetes is the first phase of insulin secretion. And that comebacks, and that's the reason he had used the word that it can be, you can call it a pathophysiologically, you have reversed the diabetes. But it does not mean that it's a prolonged reversal. It is, he has not called it's a cure for diabetes. It is the first phase of insulin secretion which had come back, and that is the primary pathophysiological defect in a type 2 diabetes. With these few words, I think today we end, and then again we meet on Monday evening, same time, 7 o'clock.
Bansi, before you end, we have the audience question, quiz question, I think.
Yes. So we are going to have,
Before we end, Anand, I was going to tell you who I think is the winner. I think the winner is the topic. Exactly. They're a very good topic. So that, you know, I was quite enthused to see the crowd getting excited about this. So this is the audience question. So this famous gentleman, please do not shout out anybody. I know many of you would know it. Don't tell the answer. This is for the audience. This famous gentleman was a painter, and he died in a plane crash in 1941. He actually, when the plane crashed, he didn't die straight away. He died after 2 days. He also helped with the invention of the G-chute, the gravitation suit to stop pilots from blacking out, because in the Second World War, pilots had to black out when the planes took a sharp turn. So he was helping with the invention of the G-chute to stop pilots from blacking out when they were subjected to G-forces while turning or diving. Who is this gentleman? Answer one, Charles Best. Second, Frederick Banting. Third, James Collip. Four, Harvey Cushing. So if you know the answer, you have to click, I think, 1, 2, 3, or 4. Just write it there. Am I right, Bansi? They have to just write the number. Yes.
And fastest finger, the top three will win.
Yeah, so Bansi, I've modified it to make it number-wise. Otherwise,
the top three, okay. I mean the first. They will be getting some gift voucher also.
I can see some of the answers streaming in because the panelists have become impatient to answer.
But the panelists cannot give the answer. It has to come from the audience only.
Well, that's, again, my mouth is shut today. Today,
Dada, khub rasgulla bhalo.
Yeah, mere ko diet ke baare mein kaun bol sakta hai, bhai?
Arde,
khana nahi khao.
Wo bhi satmi ke din. Aaj to rasgulla hi rasgulla.
Aldik, now you show the this video, and then you can show the video of next ideal, and then we
are doing
Vande Mataram.
Tired of unsolicited promotional messages from companies flooding your WhatsApp and email with zero benefits to you? Now take control of what you want to see and when you want to see.
Presenting My Uber Room. Communication by consent model. A first of its kind in India.
One of its kind, communication by consent, digital interface, exclusively for doctors. My Uber Room enables you to view promotional messages with your consent at your time and convenience. Download the My Uber Room app from Play Store or App Store. Register yourself today.
So the next ideal video.
Bansi, I welcome all of you. Bansi.
I request all panelists, all doctors here and all audience doctors, please follow our RSSDI social media page, which is on Facebook.
I Bansi, once again, you have changed my photograph.
Dr. Jamar,
you have changed my photograph here.
Dr. Jamar, we will talk later. So please follow RSSDI social media page. And I request all of you, all those delegates who are registered today, and please register and log in again on Monday evening at 7 p.m. We end by Hardik, can you play the Vande Mataram? Thank you. Vande Mataram. Vande Mataram. Sujana Sukhana Malayaj Sheetala Sasya Shyamala Mataram. Vande Mataram. Shubhra Jyotsna Pulakita Yamini Pullakusumita Drumadala Shobhini Suhasini Sumadhura Bhashini Sukhadambarada Mataram. Vande Mataram. Vande Mataram. Good night.
Good night. Good night. Be careful. Be safe.
Good night, everybody.
See you on Monday evening. Bye.
Only one take-home points. I go back with no worries about diabetes because I just need to cross over and go to Andhra Pradesh and get my diabetes.
Sir, you are most welcome, sir. Come to Guntur or Vijayawada.
Good night.
You are most welcome. We are waiting for you.
Good night. Good night.
Good night. Good night, everybody. Good night.
Good night.
Goodbye.
Good night.
Goodbye.
Thank you. Good night. Thank you.
Good night. Thank you. Well done, Assam.
Hi, Sanjay Boss.
Bye.
Hospital, one bed, one hour, okay, car, let's